This is footage of Arab tribal leaders pledging support for Turkey to reclaim their lands in northern Syria, which they were displaced from. So what's going on? As the Syrian war enters its ninth year, the conflict, which started as a popular uprising against Bashar al-Assad's regime, has turned into a messy conflict with elements of civil war, international intervention, terrorism, internal displacement, ethnic cleansing, and what seems to be state-building aspirations. So let's break it down. The protagonists in this story are first and foremost the YPG, an offshoot of the PKK terrorist organization. The group that has rebranded under the umbrella of what is dubbed the SDF, or the Syrian Democratic Forces, has received support from the US, which, despite recognizing the PKK as a terrorist organization, has not labeled the YPG or SDF as such.
They formally called themselves the YPG, who the Turks would say equated to the PKK. You're dealing with a terrorist enemy of mine. How can you do that, ally? So we literally played back to them, hey, you got to change your brand. What do you want to call yourself besides the YPG? And with about a day's notice, they declared that they were the Syrian Democratic Forces. I thought it was a stroke of brilliance to put democracy in there somewhere.
Despite using the YPG for the fight against Daesh, the YPG has been repetitively accused by human rights organizations like Amnesty International of committing war crimes in Syria. The most significant of them include the internal displacement and demolitions of homes of the local Arab population. Lema Faqih, a senior crisis advisor at Amnesty, had said in 2015,
by deliberately demolishing civilian homes, in some cases razing and burning entire villages, displacing their inhabitants with no justifiable military grounds, the autonomous administration is abusing its authority and brazenly flouting international humanitarian law in attacks that amount to war crimes.
Specifically, on this map, you can see 14 towns mentioned in the Amnesty report, where the local population fell victim to targeted displacement. Further evidence of how YPG terrorists are essentially cleaning northern Syria of its local population is shown in these satellite images. The first shows 225 buildings standing in the village of Husseina in Tell Hams in 2014, but only 14 were left a year later. The YPG has also been placing systematic pressure on other minorities in the region, specifically Syriac Christians who have protested against a closing down of schools, forced displacement, and violence towards its youth. And so these actions make the US support for the YPG over the last few years a controversial matter. Then there's the media whirlwind surrounding a Turkish invasion of northern Syria, or what has been characterized as Turkey's assault on Kurds. But what is the Turkish perspective? Since 2016, Turkey's Euphrates Shield and Olive Branch operations in northwestern Syria have liberated the region from YPG and Daesh terrorists, making it possible for nearly 400,000 Syrians who fled the violence to resettle in western Syria. Turkey, in places like Afrin, has even helped set up a Kurdish-majority local government to reflect the demographics. And today, Turkey continues its effort to not only combat terrorism, but also to keep its southern border safe and cater for the future of millions of displaced Syrians. According to Turkish officials, the current strategy of creating a 32-kilometer peace corridor spanning from the Euphrates River to the Syria-Iraq border could provide a home for 2 million Syrians. If the safe zone reaches the Deir ez-Zor-Raqqa line, that number could reach 3 million. Considering the war crimes previously mentioned and the links between the YPG and the PKK, Turkey would be dealing a serious blow to the YPG's aspirations of carving up a new state in northern Syria through the displacement of the Syrian Arab residents in the war, and will be reducing a terrorist threat that has undermined its security for the last 30 years, taking the lives of more than 40,000 people.